What's up, Rockers? We have here a set of L52 Classics. I'm going to unbox them. Let's take a look at it first. Got the, this is a much smaller version of the L100s that I have. Let's see the specifications. Actually mirror image. Nice. I actually didn't realize that. That's the other side. Alright, so I believe this one here unboxes from the no it doesn't. I thought it did. Alright. Gotta be very careful in a situation like this unboxing it just because you don't want to hit the speakers. Especially if the speakers aren't yours. I'm a little sturdy. Yeah, it's sturdy. If anyone wants to read that, they can. These are going to be utilized as rear channel speakers for now. They're not very big. Time to put this on the floor. Oh yeah. You got a little bit of weight to them though for tiny bookshelf speakers. Do you believe they consider the L100 Classics bookshelf speakers too? I think that's kind of trolling. Yeah, look at that. They're actually specified that it's left. So yeah, they're mirror images. That's pretty cool. What's in here? Looks like something's in it. Probably the grills. Definitely the grills in there. There's nothing. I see some silica gel. Got the blue specified there, the blue foam. Mini L100s. So the reason I said about not getting the L82s is because the L82s cost new with the L100 Classics cost. Yeah, they cost new with the L100 Classics cost used. So if I'm going to spend the money that I could get for a set of L100s, I want to get the L100s, not the L82s. These retail for about $1,000 a pair. I was able to get them a little bit cheaper than that, and I'm good with it. Comes in a nice fuzzy, it's nice, really nice. Ooh, yeah, look at that. I gotta be really careful with them, getting them out. Oh yeah. And you're supposed to pack a pretty decent punch for a small speaker too. I believe it. These are awesome looking. In 1 second, I actually have to blow my nose quick. I just got a Q8 tape in the mail the other day of Simon and Garfunkel's Bridge Over Troubled Water. I've been looking forward to doing the last couple of days. I was listening to the Boxer and Quad for the first time. Well, it would have worked out that way, but somebody decided that they were going to talk through the whole entire course of the song. That being said, I'm letting tape play to the end since the Boxer's track one, or the first song on program two. And the first song these speakers are going to hear is a Boxer on Q8. Alright, you guys saw this already, but for the sake of the video, we'll got this. We got the foam grill, so I'll unbox that quick. It's going to be... Be careful with it, that's all. The other grill. These are like, picture these are like JBLs you can buy for your kid's room. That's what Kevin said to me the other day as a joke. Now, these speakers are not technically for me, but I want to be using them until the rightful owner is ready for them. Just because I can. Eventually I'm going to get another set of L100s for the back. I'm thinking about running the Marantz off a separate amp, get two 250 watt per channel amplifiers, and pair them up that way. Oh yeah, they are mirror image. How about that? This should be the left one, I believe, right? No, that's actually, yeah, right one. No. Wow, so they actually have, I thought the tweeters were supposed to be out, I guess not. Huh, okay. Well, in any event, I'm good with it. Yeah, I'm good with it. Cool. Let's hear them. Alright guys, right now we're going to take a look at the JBL L52 Classics. You guys already saw what they look like out of box. Took me a few days to get to the video, but we're here now, so get a good view. I almost tripped. A good view like that. And they're paired up with the JBL L100 Classics for a complete discrete quad system. So what we're gonna do here is we got to start with, let's see, that's a disc. I still didn't clean up after myself in my last video yet. So, get this started here, and we're going to go to some Doobie Brothers. Some volume.
Is it pulling in?
Oh. Yep.
Gotta put it back to the screed and back to tape two or tape one. Start over. Very clear and very detailed speakers.
Now a lot of that's a source too, but
I tried it. These speakers sound good with anything, so I highly recommend them. JBL L52 Classics.
Mississippi moon, won't you keep on shining on me?
Okay, now the filters are back up in the front. So to be fair here, we're gonna set to the rears only. Pretty decent bass too for a tiny 5.5 inch driver speaker. Also gives you a much more in-depth experience to the music too. Bigger plays might not be the most ideal, but it works. And it's for the room I have, it's the best that I could do. So it is what it is. And it sounds good too.
Honky tonk with you all night long. I wanna hand tonk, take me by the hand, pretty mama, come and dance with your daddy all night long.
I love that screen right there. It's pretty freaking awesome, man. If you're curious about it, check out the last video I put up about the Oppo 203 Blu-ray player with the screen outputs. That goes right from that directly into the 4-channel inputs of your receiver. That's the wrong freaking tape. That's just my stereo one. Where the hell is the one that's... yeah, here it is. Yeah, sorry about that. I have a party coming up that we're getting ready for. Another party. I'll turn the fronts on a little bit, but that's with an 8-track tape too. Clear with an eight, with an old 50-year-old 8-track tape.
Virginia,
Shondells. Let's run them in stereo for a minute. So I'm gonna set it all the way to, gonna put it on two channel, click it all the way over to the rears, and we'll compare the L100 Classics to the L52 Classics with the same signal. Actually, probably should have done that first. Let's see if there's any good on the radio. Yeah. It's all the way down, so we're not gonna blast ourselves out.
It's 38 degrees, 105.5, WMGH.
And my stereo lights burned out. Yeah, the L100's a lot louder. I mean, it should be. And the L100 sound a lot better too. And they should. Whoop. Now, it's not that drastic of a difference, it's just because I'm in the other side of the room and really far away from me. Although they don't sound as big as the JBL L100s, which they are not as big as the JBL L100s, obviously, they have a much bigger sound than they look like they would. That sounds freaking great. Especially like right about here.
You're a 99.9, the Hawk.
Two for Tuesday. Well, that was queer. You hear that? They freaking cut out a part of the song. You can hear the difference between the L100 Classics and the L52 Classics. The difference is immediately obvious. And also, when I have it set up for the rears of the L52s, I have the L52s hooked into the remote on the rears. That way I can still switch them on and off and, you know, separate them if need be. Or if I'm running in stereo like I am, I have the ability to turn them off.
Tell
see what MMR's got going on. There we go. The difference in bass is probably going to be obvious for the Beastie Boys. Let's hear it quick. Yep. I like my sugar with coffee and cream. L52 Classics are a great speaker, especially taking the size into consideration. And they make an excellent candidate for the rear channels, which is what I bought them for, because most quad recordings, especially with the 5.1 recordings, don't really throw much real low end in the back channels anyway. There's some exceptions with the 4.0, but they hold their own with bass, they do. If I was only running the, if I had four L52s and no L100s, I would say maybe some people might want a subwoofer. I hate subwoofers, they're real boomy. I can never seem to get them fine-tuned correctly. I know a lot of people swear by them. And maybe it's just me, maybe it was the room. My buddies say I have great acoustics in the room. For me, everything kind of feels like a fight. But I feel like I finally got dialed in pretty good where I'm very happy with it. I drop a lot of jaws when I have non-audiophile people over. They go, oh man, that's awesome. I'm like, yeah, it's not bad, right? So, ideally, I'd like to have four L100 Classics, which would be $8,000 in speaker systems instead of $5,000. However, like I said, look at the room. Room-wise, I really don't have room to fit. JBL L82 Classics won't fit up on the shelves. This one's not a problem, I can move it down. But right here, I'm kind of limited to what I can do, especially being I got the air conditioner there. The ideal space for that speaker would be perfectly across, which would be like right here. But obviously, that's not going to happen. Unless I get the breezeway closed in and have this wall taken out and put the air conditioner in the front like I wanted to do and have a bigger living room. But that's not gonna happen. I think I'm gonna the compromise isn't worth the prize, so I think I'm just gonna leave it the way it is and build my sunroom on out back, and that'll be the end of it. And I think this is gonna stay the way it is, especially since we get so much enjoyment out of the breezeway. If I'm getting off topic here, so yeah, the L100 Classics are definitely a better speaker all the way around, but they should be. These are $4,000. These are $1,000. And also, the other reason I didn't go with the L82 Classics, other than not having a place to put them, which is the same problem I have with these, the L100, the L82 Classics cost the same price new as a set of these does used. So if I'm going to spend that kind of money, I'm just get another. I would just get another set of the L100s. So the L52 Classics are very affordable. They're very good speakers. They're detailed, refined. They have the whole vocal range covered. They have the highs, mids and bass come from the same driver, because these are just a two-way speaker, which you saw in the unboxing video. And I did have the grills off, so you saw that they are actually mirror image, whereas the L100 Classics are not. This position I have in them doesn't really do much for the image anyway. I mean, it still gives you a nice pinpoint position, puts you in the center of the music, but if I have them vertical like they're supposed to be, it would be a lot better. But again, I can do that here, but not there. And these do have a mount for a speaker bracket, which I thought about using. But again, I come into the same problem. I can't mount a speaker bracket on the AC unit. So yeah, it is what it is. So yeah, these are very good speakers. I highly recommend them. And don't let the comparison to the L100s fool you. These are just amazing speakers all the way around. They're the best sounding speakers I've ever heard in my life, honestly, they are. That might say a lot for what kind of speakers I've listened to. Some people probably disagree with that statement. But putting these aside, these are also amazing speakers, and would honestly, they're definitely the best sounding small bookshelf speakers I've ever heard. There's no question, no comparison. So take that for the review for what it is. Hey, if you have any questions, comments, concerns, you know what to do. Drop me a line. I will get back to you. I always appreciate you guys' feedback and input. So that being said, rock on, peace out. Catch you next time.